What the fuck was that?
I'm coming, Papa Bear.
Wasteland 3's last DLC has finally come out. Cult of the Holy Detonation is, quite literally, an explosive finale. This time around, you get a distress call from a Colorado Springs scientist named Theo Curie, who is looking into an active nuclear hotspot that he wants to tap in to see if he can redirect some of its nuclear energy to power the rest of Colorado, while another party warns you of its danger level and request that it be shut down instead. This is located in the Cheyenne Mountain Complex. It may look and sound familiar to you. That's because it's a real military bunker built inside a mountain in Colorado, and it's also appeared in the 1983 film War Games. Shh, we're not supposed to talk about it. So anyway, there's like this giant thermo time bomb inside the Cheyenne Mountain Complex. And it's in the hands of a dangerous radioactive cult who formed their own religion around it, referring to it as the Holy Detonation, and as one of the instruments that created the deluge of fire, in Wasteland's terms, the nuclear event that caused the apocalypse. In order to achieve some degree of control over the bomb, you will need to work with these delusional bunches for a while and try to settle a civil issue that is happening within that causes separation into two cults, the Primordialists and the Nucleus. Will you try to resolve this matter peacefully, or will you kill the opposing Nucleus in full support of the Primordialists, or kill them both? Will you share the bomb's power with the rest of the world, or shut it down completely? Wasteland games have always delivered when it comes to replay value, and this DLC is no exception from the rest. You'll often come across a fork in the road that will probably make you want to keep spare saves when confronted with big decisions. It's too bad that you can only have 10 manual saves at a time in Wasteland 3, at least on Xbox One. I'm all out of manual saves. Someone please help me with this! Like the Battle of Steeltown, Cult of the Holy Detonation also adds a couple new gameplay elements of its own that distinguishes it from the base game. First off is the radiation effect that boosts some of your stats like strength and hit points, but at the cost of some other stats like decreased speed or aim. More importantly, having the glowing effect applied to your team can make it easier to pass dialogue checks with Nucleus to convince them to let you pass without a fight, as well as unlocking certain story dialogue options a lot easier. The biggest game changer, though, is the change of combat itself. In this DLC, most mandatory fights make you complete certain objectives in order to win matches instead of simply taking out every enemy. Because of enemy spawners that call up endless waves of reinforcements, this can often require you to split your team up into two so one can complete the objectives while the other is on defense. I found this DLC to be considerably more challenging than Steeltown due to this, but to me it felt like an even more rewarding and satisfying experience. I can say that I do like what this one introduced more. I find that the radiation and objective-based combat was implemented better than the non-lethal effects exclusive to Steeltown. While we're on the subject of comparing DLCs, I do find it strange how cheaper this one is. It has the same level of content as Steeltown, yet it's half the price. Steeltown being $14 and this one only $7. The season pass is $20. So I feel like both of these should have been around $11 each, but whatever. As far as bang for your buck goes, this one wins, but if you like Wasteland 3 and haven't bought either of these, I highly recommend the Season Pass, which is definitely worth the $20 for both. Now with that being said, there are a couple of problems I had with Steeltown that unfortunately carry over to Cult of the Holy Detonation. Thankfully, it didn't crash on me at all this time around, so I hope that means crashing has been patched out once and for all. But the game still occasionally suffers from bugs relating to user interface, or AI squad mates that get stuck when moving to use their skills on something. But But yeah, aside from that, I've loved both of these expansions. They're cleverly designed, highly replayable, with plenty of content on the side. Maybe not so much Cult of the Holy Detonation. There was one or maybe two side missions to keep you busy. But there's also not quite as much dirty poop humor. Just this one giant mound of shit you can keep reaching in. The exploration is again very fulfilling, and even has a few hidden Easter eggs to find from previous games, including my favorite. Yay! Candy!
Friends? Candy? Yay, candy!
My final score for Wasteland 3, Cult of the Holy Detonation, is going to be the same as what I gave the base game and the Battle of Steeltown, a solid 8 out of 10. It's kind of sad though, knowing there won't be more content for this. But hey, maybe if we work hard enough we could back these devs up again to make a Wasteland 1 remake maybe? That remaster last year simply wasn't enough. We need a full-fledged remake with 3's gameplay and maybe 2's exploration. Make it the perfect Wasteland game. Please make it so. Oh, and Wasteland 4 in the far future, of course.
The Gamer Gods!
Fail! Candy! Yay, candy! Candy! Yay! So much good candy! Sleepy now! Good night!